good?
Yeah.
Good shot?
Wow. This is just like E. Except okay. More professional.
Okay. I'm gonna give
three
you some
cameras,
seconds,
amazing. Six, five, four, and we are cut.
Okay.
And we are live. Do not fuck this up. Three. I like to do the. Three, two, one, go! It's a weird thing. I do the opposite of being silent.
Dead puppies. Okay.
Oh. What a weird. Why not say dead owls?
Because it's not
mascot.
As sad.
It's not as sad?
No.
You hear that, Rowan TV? Katie has no feelings.
Welcome
to Cute Lady Dressed as a Bellboy. And action.
Hi, we're Rowan ready. University, and welcome back to this segment with Joel McHale. My name
welcome
is
welcome back to the segment that is starting now. Rowan TV Network. RTN. This is
can I have a 5 seconds for
me?
Five, four, three, two, one, interview!
Hello, Rowan University. My name is Katie Bovoso, and you're watching RTN Channel 5.
Katie
I'm
Bovoso.
Here. Katie Bovoso. That is me. Hopefully
French?
You're gonna watch this. Italian.
Oh.
Yeah. Chinese. I don't think this man needs any interview, but this
nope,
right here.
Nope, I don't need an interview.
We're just
all right. I'll see you guys later.
This, everyone, is Joel McHale.
Mm-hmm. Katie, I'm going to look into this camera the entire time.
That's fine. Every once in a while, we'll just have you staring
right.
longingly with the audience.
Okay.
I love it.
Action.
I do have to say, it's a fantastic feeling to be here in your presence,
mm-hmm.
the same presence as somebody who knows Chris Hardwick. So thank you so much.
I'll let him know you said that.
Please do. I'm a
we could call him.
We could call him?
No.
Ah, got really excited.
Because then you'd see his number.
You could just hold it up and text back. But thank you so much for coming here today.
I will let Chris know you said that.
Please do. Mm-hmm. I follow him. And anyway, this is about you.
Do you follow me?
I do. And I tweeted you today, and you didn't tweet me back. So I have some strong
like
words
2 weeks
for you.
Ago,
yeah, I don't
yeah.
read them.
I knew
how many
it
followers
you.
Do you have?
I have like 93.
Oh, that's so cute.
I do it on my own. I don't just like
you
go
follow
on.
Yourself.
No,
you just create accounts.
I tweet
follow
really cool
Katie
things.
Katie Bambabosa.
Oh,
I tweet really cool things, and I wait for people to see it and then
right.
follow me.
Okay. I will totally tweet you tomorrow.
I'm going to expect it. Nope.
Not a chance.
Dreams dashed. Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway.
How many years have you been going to this school?
This is actually my second year, but
sophomore.
It's my, no, it's my last semester. I transferred from a community college.
See?
Oh my goodness.
Success stories.
Absolutely. So
that's
I will
great.
Be graduating in 4 years.
Wow.
How long have you been going here?
I've been going here for 4.5 hours. It's
well,
been really great.
I do have to segue from that. I did find out. I did find out you went to Washington University.
Nope.
No.
I did
heard
not go to Washington University.
Tell me which school.
The University of Washington.
The University of Washington.
Right.
I have
so if I was like
my bad.
Rowan School of Culinary Arts, you'd be like, no, it doesn't exist.
We do not even have culinary
but
arts.
So
at
far,
least I
good
had your
job
words
on the research.
In a different order. Thanks.
Washington
my
College.
My producer is just yelling at me. By the way, wit guy who told me that, rewrite your sentence there. Anyway.
Yeah. Somebody's in trouble.
And you did play football there.
I did play football.
Can you tell me what position you played?
Nope. I do not remember.
That's fine. Well, he did win a Rose Bowl ring.
I won it.
You did?
But it was in one of those machines that has the claw. And I spent like $15.
Trying to get it. $15 in quarters.
Yeah, it took hours. And I finally got that thing. Well, yes, I was not rewarded the ring because of good playing. I was really good at showing the defense how well they tackled. They were like, I'm terrific at this. I gave them a real false sense
terrific
of success.
At kissing the ground. But still, you were part of a team. But I did find out that you weren't a huge fan of school in general.
I was not a huge fan of school.
Can you tell
that's
me why?
That's why I'm here at Rowan today.
What are you trying to say? We don't have a real mascot?
No, I'm saying people come here to not get educated. No.
Only half the time.
No, it seems like a very nice university.
Thank you.
University was not really for me. I spent a lot of time doing a lot of extracurricular things, mostly crime. And I did not really want to be there, but I met a lot of nice people.
Oh, wonderful.
No, and so if I had to, it wasn't like if I had to do it all over again, I would, it was, but like I should have probably just gone to some sort of acting conservatory or something like that.
There you go.
Because I spent most of my time screwing around.
Well, what made you want to get into being a comedian, basically? Into
the
this
money.
Entire, the money?
The money and the clothes.
As soon as it started
and the cars.
Out. that didn't come immediately for most people that I know.
I know, but it's weird. In Seattle, it's the opposite. They're like, oh, comedian.
In Seattle, Washington.
Here's a sports car and a
booming
cape.
City of Seattle, Washington.
Yes. The booming city?
The booming city.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, like, we got Twilight everything. Was there.
Twilight?
Twilight was just in outside Forks? Of it. Because that existed.
Wait, have you seen that movie?
No.
Oh, that's a surprise.
I just, anyway. Well, with everything that you do in stand-up, what made you want to go put that towards movies? You did mention acting. Do you really like acting a lot more than you like stand-up, or would you rather...
I hate them equally.
Okay.
No, if you looked on Wikipedia, which, no, you did. No, but I started out as an actor, mm-hmm. and then I got the soup, and I was not a stand-up at that point, and then after the soup...
It just feels like you're so natural with it. I'm surprised.
I'm pretty drunk.
Oh, okay.
And so that came afterwards. I kind of backed into it because my agent said, you're going to make a lot of money if you go on the road telling soup jokes. And so I went, really, how much? And he goes, this much. And I was like, I'm at, and then much like the Roadrunner disappearing. but after I did it 1,000 times, then I sucked way less at it. And I didn't just get on stage for an hour and start doing it. That was because I would be killed by the audience. But I invited my friends, Chris Hardwick did a bunch of shows, guys who knew what they were doing, and I would host the show, and I would do material in between, and people were like, he doesn't have to do an hour, he just tells jokes in between, and that's where I kind of put it together. So, but I went to L.A. to be an actor, and mm-hmm. because Greg Kinnear, who hosted Talk Soup way before you were born, he went on to be an actor from that, I thought, well, if I can just get noticed on the Soup, then the acting, hopefully I'll get noticed for acting stuff. And that happened, but I didn't. Kinnear left Talk Soup, but I stayed with the Soup because I love it so much.
Do you hate when the Soup gets compared to Tosh.0?
No, I mean, you mean like, hey, they are like you, or you're like them.
But with the internet, either
right.
way.
Right. Well, it's not like there's a monopoly or a patent on the format. Mm-hmm. There's 1,001 late night talk shows that have. Basically the same. They use all the same format. It's just what you're doing with it. So no, I don't hate it at all. And I was just on his show last month.
We did actually. We saw that, and I'm surprised about how tall the both of you are.
Well, so. It's on camera, so you can't really tell. Much like Seacrest and I are the same height on camera.
That's very true.
Yeah, but you and I are looking eye to eye right now.
Yeah, actually, I don't know.
And
how
I'm 7'1", and you're what?
I'm
four?
Like 6'8".
See, there you go. Same height.
Huge on camera. Absolutely. I'm like Kate Upton. I wish.
Right. Maria Sharapova.
Yeah, exactly.
6'2".
Except I cannot play tennis for the life of me.
Well, this interview's over.
And he's leaving.
That's it.
Well, how do you feel about doing the entire...
He would like you to do
I
an impression.
I see 2 minutes and then we go to wrap up.
Yeah, what
thanks,
the hell?
Guys. This is my impression of my
this
producer
This is actually
right now.
For... She
two
would
minutes,
like you, he would like you to act like
up.
A squirrel. Or like a gerbil. In a wheel.
Like gerbil in a wheel. Like Kourtney Kardashian mixed with Ryan Seacrest.
Right.
It was a hamster in a wheel.
Hamster.
I watched. I did. I went out there and I didn't sit in here the entire time twiddling my thumbs.
You went out there for like 10 or 15 minutes?
I went out there for the whole time.
Wow.
You actually went longer than we expected, so I missed the last 10 minutes, so you have to repeat it.
Oh, all right. Here goes. there was this guy. I was out there. I go too long. I agree.
No, but it was really enjoyed. I do have to ask. I think you do something that a lot of people would dream of doing, and it's just
joke on stage.
Mm-hmm. I've been doing it a lot tonight. So how do you feel about being able to just go and say whatever you want to audiences and to national TV every week about terrible TV?
It's great. No.
End of story. Bye, guys.
It, you know, we are very deeply, it's great because the show is cathartic in mm-hmm. that I was yelling back at my television while sitting in my underwear at home for many years. I think a lot of people do that, and I think it's an extension of that. But we are always deeply concerned about the construction of the jokes and whether mm-hmm. they're good or not. And so it's not, and we do get to say pretty much whatever we want, but if it's not funny, then I don't want to say it.
Then you don't want to, obviously. Yes.
That's the greatest measure. If we find it funny, then good. But I can get very pissed at myself. I mean, I get tortured by the show if I'm like, that was a terrible joke. And so it's a burden. It's a cross. I'm there.
Are there any of the shows that you do badmouth that you actually watch?
I hardly now watch any television because when Community is in full swing, I have no time to hardly eat. But when it's off season, I will watch. I like The Ultimate Fighter a lot. I did like Deadliest Catch when it was on. I like Dirty Jobs. I like Small Town Security. I used to really be into. I used to really like American Idol, but.
Did Ryan make you watch it?
Yes. Well, he paid me. It was too hard to keep. It's too hard to keep up with what's happening and when with my schedule. So thank God for the 13 people that watch television. So I can tell you pretty much what the hell's going on. I just don't watch them from end to end.
Well, I don't think you always need to. But you mentioned Community. Just a couple more questions, then I'll let you run out of here. You mentioned Community, and I know that's been such a great program, such a great show in general. I've watched
it. It's your favorite show, right?
It is at my absolute favorite show. Now, I know people on it. I do watch it. I really enjoy it. Yes. We have a lot of fans in the room.
Right. What's my character's name?
Joel. Anyway. I know Donald Glover is still a big fan of Donald Glover. Thank you.
What's Donald Glover's? What's Donald Glover's?
Donald, I can't.
What's Donald Glover's character's name?
Donald. Anyway.
She loves the show.
Love the
it's
show.
Her favorite show.
I am
show.
A bigger suit
She's
fan
seen a lot of episodes of this thing that I think
like
that you are on.
Like you.
Did you like the
College
episode with
going
the,
crazy.
Did you like the episode with the submarine?
I like the episode with the pillow fight.
Okay.
I can tell you that.
So you saw
I
that.
Really enjoyed
Great.
It.
Great. All right. Good. Thank you.
I am trying. I can't always remember people's names, but I do know what the show is about.
No, it's okay. What's it about?
It's about a community college.
Oh.
It's like this. But smaller.
Oh, all right. Nailed it. Sweet.
Was that something that you wanted to get into before you started with the soup, before you started with everything else? Was
into
it something
pillow fighting?
Into writing, a comedy
I didn't write
TV
it.
Show.
I don't write.
Well, into being a part of a TV show in general, a comedy TV show like that.
You mean
were you
the sitcom?
Yes.
The sitcom. Yes. As I said, that you know, with the soup, I was right. hoping to get, you know, the auditions that I had been banging my head against a wall to get, and then I got the Community audition, and yes.
Yes, thank you.
Definitely. Definitely. Well, I was thrilled to get it, because I knew that the writing was the best I'd ever read.
I do really enjoy seeing you on the suit, being able to be such a loud person, and then on Community, you never really know what character you're going to play. A lot of the times I see you reserved, and then you break out with this almost just this hysterical banter, and it's really interesting the way that you have so many different characters. So I do applaud you on your acting.
Thank
I have
you.
To tell
well,
you.
Jeff Winger, which is not my character's name. Third person, but he becomes very impassioned at times, and he gives a lot of speeches.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's a lot of dialogue.
And yes, so yeah, I think he spends most of the episodes trying not to be interested, but he completely is.
Well, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you,
Joel.
Katie. Very
I feel
well.
Like we've been having so much fun and so much for 4 minutes, but thank you.
How long did Louis Katz go? How long did Louis Katz go?
We had a hard 5 minutes. Yeah. With
he was
Louis.
Like, no.
He's like this.
We also had to get him on stage. Now you're here.
True.
You did your whole thing. We can keep
true.
You forever.
It's just letting it out. Well, thank you.
Thank you, Joel.
We'll see you on the red carpet.
I really hope so. I'm really hoping so. News
we'll
reporter,
see,
personality.
We won't see you on the red carpet.
We'll be hiding under the carpet.
Maybe you. I'm kidding. All right, so you're all going to Los Angeles? You're all going to New York?
Actually, might be
this. Yeah.
See, look at this.
Yeah, I was in New York this summer. Well, thank you, Rowan University, for watching. We still haven't closed that out, but this has been Joel McHale. I'm
yeah.
Katie Bavosa.
Three, two,
one. Bye.
Action! Go ahead with the interview.